In our parasha, Moshe tells the Jewish people of the mitzvah of the Arei Mikla, the cities of refuge. The cities of refuge were places where a person who had, God forbid, killed a person inadvertently could flee. We're concerned that perhaps the members of the family of the victim would be fueled by rage and they would want to kill the person who had killed their relative, and therefore the person was entitled to flee to a city of refuge. He was looked after there, he had whatever he needed there, and he had to stay there until the death of the Kohen Gadol. And the Torah tells us how many cities of refuge there were. Actually, in total, there were 48, because the Leviim had 42 cities, and their cities doubled as cities of refuge. But the actual cities of refuge themselves were six. There were three in the land of Canaan proper, in the land of Israel proper, and there were three east of the Jordan, in the area which was occupied by the 2.5 tribes, Reuven, Gad, and the tribe of Manasseh. Because as we recall at the end of the book of Bamidbar, Reuven and Gad came to Moshe and they said, look, we have a lot of livestock. This area here, which we've conquered from the kings of Sihon and the king Og, it's a beautiful area. It's very lush. There's a lot of pasture. We want to live here. We don't want to go and receive our inheritance in the land of Israel. And Moshe at first was very upset, but in the end they came to a deal, and he said to them that you first have to go and help the rest of the nation, the rest of the tribes, to fight in the land of Canaan, and then you can come back and you can receive your inheritance here east of the Jordan in an area called the Gilad. And so it was. So you had 9.5 tribes living west of the Jordan, and you had 2.5 tribes living east in the Jordan. In the area west of the Jordan, there were three cities of refuge, and in the area east of the Jordan, there were three cities of refuge. And here the commentators, in fact, the Talmud asks an interesting question. It doesn't seem to be the right proportion. Why were there just as many cities of refuge east of the Jordan as there were west of the Jordan? There were far more tribes. There was a far bigger population west of the Jordan. There were 9.5 tribes there. They should have had perhaps five cities of refuge, and then east of the Jordan, there should have been one city of refuge. Why was it three there and three here? And the Talmud gives the following answer. It says, because in Gilad, Nefishi Rotzchim, there were lots of murderers east of the Jordan, and therefore they needed more cities of refuge. And this is an answer that Rashi also gives in his commentary to the book of Bamidbar. However, that doesn't really answer the question. So what if there were lots of murderers east of the Jordan? That's not our concern. Murderers did not get to go to the city of refuge. A person who murdered in cold blood, that person was tried and put to death. They weren't allowed to go to the city of refuge. The city of refuge was only for a person who killed inadvertently. The example given by the Torah is that a person went to chop wood in the forest and they were chopping with an axe, and the axe handle broke away from the head of the axe and it went flying and it struck someone and that person died. It was a mistake. Yes, there was a bit of negligence, but it was a mistake. That's the type of person who goes to a city of refuge. So what difference does it make that in the territory of Gilad, east of the Jordan, there were lots of murderers? That doesn't describe why you need cities of refuge. And the Maharal provides for us a fantastic answer. And he says it's true that the city of refuge is only for a person who kills by mistake. But because in the area of Gilad, there were lots of murders, people who killed on purpose, that meant that there was a casual attitude to life. Life was cheap in the Gilad. And we're in an area and in an atmosphere where life is cheap, then even people who don't kill on purpose become a little bit complacent, become a little bit negligent. And therefore in the Gilad, you even had a lot of deaths that were caused by mistake, but far more than in the area west of the Jordan, because there was a casual attitude to life. This is something that we in South Africa have to think about very, very seriously. We live here, especially us who live in the Western Cape. It's unfortunately the murder capital of South Africa. Life is very cheap. You hear on the Cape Flats about murders and rapes and the most terrible violence. And of course, those people are doing it on purpose. But when we treat life very casually, then even the good people begin to have a casual outlook towards life and that life is cheap. And this is something that we should never allow. And that's what the Torah was emphasizing, that if you live in a place where there's a lot of murderers, then even the good people are affected. So you have to choose very carefully where you live, and you have to make sure that you always view life as sacrosanct and the most holy thing that Hashem gave us. I wish you a Shabbat Shalom.